morning.
In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Grace and peace of our Lord Jesus Christ, fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with all of you.
And with your spirit.
Continue to understand this Lenten time, prayer, fasting, but of the Lord's compassion to us, our sins. God is out of darkness into light. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You give us understanding and peace. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You plead for us at the right hand of the Father. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on all of us. Forgive us of our sins. Bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. Almighty God, to serve you is to reign. Grant that with the help of St. Casimir's intercession, we may constantly serve you in holiness and justice. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the book of the prophet Jeremiah. Thus says the Lord, cursed is the man who trusts in human beings, who seeks his strength in flesh, whose heart turns away from the Lord. He is like a barren bush in the desert that enjoys no change of scenery, but stands in a lofty waste, a salt and empty earth. Blessed is the man who trusts in the Lord, whose hope is the Lord. He is like a tree planted beside the waters that stretches its roots out to the stream. He fears not the heat when it comes, its leaves stay green. In the year of drought, it shows no distress, but still bears fruit. For torture, more torturous than all else, is the human heart beyond remedy. Who can understand it? I, the Lord alone, broke the mind and test the heart, to reward everyone according to his ways, according to the merit of his deeds. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Our responsory psalm, blessed are they who hope in the Lord.
Blessed are they who hope in the Lord.
Blessed the man who follows not the counsel of the wicked, nor walks in the ways of sinners, nor sits in the company of the insolent, but delights in the law of the Lord and meditates on his law day and night.
Blessed are they who hope in the Lord.
He is like a tree planted near running water that yields its fruit in due season and whose leaves never fade. Whatever he does prospers.
Blessed are they who hope in the Lord.
Not so the wicked, not so. They are like chaff which the wind drives away. For the Lord watches over the way of the just, but the way of the wicked vanishes.
Blessed are they who hope in the Lord.
Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke.
Glory to you, Lord.
Jesus said to the Pharisees, there was a rich man who was dressed in purple garments and fine linen and dined each day. Lying at his door was a poor man named Lazarus, covered with sores, who would gladly have eaten to fill the scraps that fell from the rich man's table. Dogs even used to come and lick his sores. And the man died, he was carried away to the bosom of Abraham. The rich man also died and was buried in the netherworld, where he was tormented and raised his eyes and saw Abraham far off and Lazarus at his side. He cried out, "Father Abraham, have pity on me. Send Lazarus to dip the tip of his finger in water, cool my tongue, for I am suffering torment in these flames." Abraham replied, "My child, remember that you received what was good during your lifetime, while Lazarus likewise received what was bad. For now is the comfortable here, whereas you are in torment. Moreover, between us and you are a great chasm that is established to prevent anyone from crossing, from might go from one side to your side to our side, and our side to yours." He said, "Then I beg you, Father, send him to my father's house, for I have five brothers, so that they may be warned, lest they too come to this terrible place." Abraham replied, "They have Moses and the prophets. Let them listen to them." And he said, "Oh no, Father Abraham, but if someone was from the dead goes to them, they will repent." And Abraham said, "If they will not listen to Moses and the prophets, neither will they pursue if someone to arise from the dead." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
I've always liked this analogy or this phrase, "the great chasm is between us." You don't hear that word too often, but I just can imagine it to maybe like the Grand Canyon between here and heaven. Something that cannot be crossed, something that cannot be easily traveled. And it just reminds me today that, you know, our lives are, we are here today, we are here in our lives, trying to understand this relationship, put it into practice, so that in some manner, not just in the next world, but this world, there is no chasm. There is no chasm. Remember when I was younger, being able to jump, you know, across streams, and I don't know if the streams got wider now, or I just can't jump as far, but it's difficult. And there's fear. We shouldn't have that. We should just be able to have this connectivity with our God, with our Lord. And it should be just on a daily basis, so that we can not feel parted. We cannot feel separated. One of the things I think is separating so much right now is the negativity that we have. This negativity that's prevalent all over. We try like anything to get away from it, but as we can do that in our mind, because we know our God is with us, because there's no chasm there as long as we put Him first, as long as we serve Him.
Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Share these our prayers.
present oblations, O Lord, in which we commemorate blessed Casimir, bestow on your faithful, we pray, the gifts of unity and peace. Ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
Lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It's right.
Right and just our duty of salvation. We always give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, eternal God. For through your bodily fast, you restrain our faults, raise up our minds, bestow your virtue, and your works through Christ our Lord. Through him, the praise and majesty, dominions and authority of powers tremble before you, heaven and the virtues of heaven, and the blessed seraphim worship together, as we say, Holy,
holy, holy, holy, holy Lord God of hosts. Heaven and earth are full of your glory. The Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is the one who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Spirit.
With his peace to one another.
Peace be with the church. Peace, peace be with the church.
Lamb and child.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sin of the world. Happy are those called to suffer the
sin, Lord,
my sin, my burden, my soul shall be healed.
The prayer of spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things and desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen. Amen.
Lord, be with you.
And with your spirit.
Blessing the Lord be upon you, Father, and Son, and Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace.
Thanks be to God.
Have a blessed, wonderful day.
You too, Father.